Firefighters of Reddit, what's the dumbest way you've seen someone accidentally start a house fire? Based on the stories from relatives, the answer is by allowing 10 years worth of dryer lint to accumulate inside the machine until it just bursts into flames. It was not an isolated case. They had two candles, and yeah, one thing led to another and they burned down their home. My dad was a firefighter, and he once went to a house fire that was started by the old lady who lived there. She liked to burn candles, but didn't like the wax buildup that would form in the cavity, so she would soak up the liquid wax with a napkin. She was doing this when she accidentally brushed a wax-soaked napkin up against the flame. She panicked and threw the napkin into the trash, where all the other wax napkins were. As the trash can exploded into flames, she fled the house, but not before she went to her oxygen tanks and flooded the house with pure oxygen, because she thought that it would smother the fire. Not a firefighter, but happened in my building. In India, generally you have small praying place in your house, like a little version of a temple. You lit DR lamp every day and pray there. In this particular case, the family decided to keep this thing on a Fukan refrigerator. The DR fell behind the fridge due to wind from the window adjacent to it. The condenser caught fire and literally exploded. The whole floor was on fire. Luckily, no one was home. It really was a dumb decision to keep the temple on a Fukan fridge. The old turkey fryer on the wood deck is always a favorite. Forgetting to close the bottom of your grill, then going overboard with the lighter fluid. Teenager was charcoal grilling in the attached garage during the winter. When done, he decided the best place to dispose of the hot coals was into a cardboard box in front corner of the garage closest to the house. Yeah, it went about as well as you can imagine. I am a firefighter, but this wasn't in my district. A guy was attempting to forge a sword. https://www.timesunion.com/news/article/man-who-started-kahos-lays-while-forging-sword-1275301-2.php in a burn barrel in an alley. Based on something he watched on the History Channel, the embers from the forge lit up the building he lived in and destroyed three multifamily residential building. Not a house fire, but really good. Late 1980s, guy was driving an old beat-up Lincoln. He turned a corner to go up a steep hill, but the road department had recently ground the asphalt down in preparation to repave a storm sewer. Manhole cover was sticking up about 4 inches. As he went over it and up the hill, the rear of his car dragged due to the pavement height difference, and the manhole ripped open his fuel tank and sparked off a gas. Guy described it. I heard a scraping sound, looked in the mirror, and there was this trail of fire chasing me up the hill, like I was the roadrunner. He pulled into a gravel parking lot and tried to kick a break in the trail before the fire got there, but it jumped the gap and lit the car. By the time we got there, it lost was his wife's purse with her license and credit cards. The car was insured, and they got a pretty nice payout for it. In the city of Colorado Springs, the local news did a fluff piece about candle safety near Christmas. After they were done filming, the store owner that they were filming in took the crew out to breakfast. She didn't put out the candles and burned several shops to the ground. The film crew was there to film her breakdown when they realized what caused the fire. This happened this past fall, but a family had a fairy house that was outside, right next to their woodside house. The fairy house was made out of an old tree and had a bunch of decorations in it, including incense candles. One evening, they decided that they would light the candles for the fairies, which then caught the tree on fire, which then extended into the house. Since it started on the outside, it ran up the side of the house and got into the attic and second floor. The family was home, but in the first floor while this was happening. It wasn't until someone driving on the road saw the smoke and went to alert the family. Luckily, we were able to save the structure. There was a bit of damage to the roof, attic and second floor, but I worked for a restoration company. A family cut a small tree down and tried to stuff it up their fireplace to burn. The flute was so crammed with leaves that smoke started to fill the living room. They tried to pull the tree out. And that's when it really caught fire. They tried to pull it out of the house. They got as far as the front door. All of them had second, third degree burns on their hands, arms, and the fire destroyed the front room and entryway of their house. The insurance company asked us if we thought it was a case of fraud, and we told them, no, these people are just really stupid. In college, a girl in the dorms was making popcorn, which not sure how that somehow caught fire in the microwave. She didn't want to get into trouble for it, so she grabbed the flaming bag of popcorn and threw it into the nearby trash can, then proceeded to cover the fire with paper towels to smother it. She actually thought it would work. It did not work. I came back exhausted after work to find the dorm building surrounded by fire trucks. A Roomba knocked a scented of candle over and set fire to the rest of the room. The guy said he knew the Roomba did it because he watched the whole thing happen, but didn't do anything because he thought it was funny. My father was a Boston firefighter for 30 plus years. One of his more memorable stories was a foreign family who had ripped up their cast iron bathtub and built an open flame underneath the tub. They used the tub as a giant oil fryer. Naturally, this didn't work out very well and the house caught fire. To add to the insanity even more, the family absolutely refused to let my dad and his co-workers in without taking their boots off, which of course they couldn't agree to. Just